Good morning, everyone, and welcome to our webinar on how to convert spreadsheets into web applications. My name is David Peach, and I'm a business development manager for MRC. We've been in business since 1981, and we're the company behind the Empower web application development platform. So, a couple of rules today. If you have any questions, please put them in the chat session, and we'll endeavor to address all the questions at the end, or you can contact us after the event. Here's a quick overview of what we'll be covering today. First, we'll explore some of the business risks of spreadsheets. Then we'll move on and examine some of the advantages of moving your spreadsheets to a database. Finally, we'll go through a quick demo. We'll convert a spreadsheet into a database table and then build a web app over the top. Sound good? All right, let's get started. Why are spreadsheets so dangerous? Well, first off, let's clarify something. Spreadsheets by themselves aren't dangerous if used in the way they were designed to be used. They were designed to be used as a single-user tool. Unfortunately, spreadsheets make it easy for single users to quickly manipulate data, but the problem is businesses use them in ways that they were never intended. They turn spreadsheets into multi-user and multi-department tools. You've heard of spreadmarts, and they're all over the place in corporate America. They store critical business data in these spreadsheets. Some even run their businesses off of their spreadsheets. So why is this misuse such a problem? When you let multiple users access and edit a single spreadsheet, the probability of error skyrockets. Here are two scary stats for you. One study found that 88% of spreadsheets contain serious errors. What does this mean for business? Based on known spreadsheet-caused business incidents, it's estimated that spreadsheets have caused $11.5 billion worth of damage. And after you see some of the examples, that number might seem low. So what causes these errors? Let's go over a few. Before we do that, let's show a few examples. Perhaps you heard of the London Whale debacle. Well, you might have known as Excel was partly to blame. JP Morgan operated a financial modeling program through Excel, which relied on manually copying and pasting data. Process that opened the door for spreadsheet errors. A second case, during the implementation of a new accounting standard at Fannie Mae, a simple spreadsheet mistake resulted in $1.136 billion error in shareholder equity. Finally, what was described as a simple cut-and-paste error in Excel resulted in a large Canadian power generator buying more transmission at a higher cost than it should have, resulting in a $24 million loss. The biggest issue is simplicity. Spreadsheets are so simple, anyone can use them. The problem is they have everything simple, even mistakes. But errors aren't so easy to catch. So you may make a spreadsheet error one day, but not catch it for months. Or another user may make a mistake, nobody realizes it. Big problem, there are all types of ways to make a spreadsheet error, but few ways to catch them. For instance, some common errors include entering the wrong data, garbage in, garbage out, or referencing the wrong cell in a formula. These errors are easy to make, but hard to catch. Another cause, spreadsheet errors, you can't control them. For instance, suppose person A creates a spreadsheet, he mails it to person B. Person B wants input from person C, so he forwards it over. Person C shares it with person D, and so on. Now, this is a common scenario, and I'm sure you can see the problem with this. You can't control spreadsheets. By the time person A gets it back from person B, how do they know who's edited it? How do they know what the errors are in it? They don't. Finally, spreadsheets are confusing. Specifically, spreadsheets created by others are confusing. One person's idea of a simple spreadsheet may be completely incomprehensible to another. This leads to misunderstanding data, which can become an expensive business mistake. I could go on, but there are many reasons why spreadsheets contain errors. One last thing on an example. There are sites dedicated to these sorts of stories. I'd recommend you check out the European Spreadsheet Internet Group site. It's a group that was formed to help business deal with the growing spreadsheet problem, and it also lists quite a few horror stories. The point of these stories is to highlight the major risks of spreadsheets. Simple mistakes go unnoticed until it's too late. So the question becomes, how can you avoid these risks? If you move your spreadsheet to a database, you can create web apps over that data. This approach gives you better data security and more control, better data accessibility, and makes your data 100%, 100 times more useful. Let me quickly explain each point. First, Moving your spreadsheet to a database gives you better data control and security. In a spreadsheet, you can't control your data. You don't know who mails it to whom and who edits it. In a database, your data is safer. You don't worry about multiple spreadsheet versions floating around. You control the data, user access, and even add advanced security options, such as multi-tenant security. This means you can give all users access to the same data, but control which aspects of that data each one can see. Let me quickly show you what multi-tenant security looks like. Here's a simple mapping app, and you can see that I can log in anywhere from the bottom, the manager in the north. Let me click on. You'll notice I have a state view of everything here. You'll notice I can click on states that are outside of my territory, but I cannot do any analysis. Those inside my territory, I can click on and all the way down as far as I would like from an analysis point of view. If I go from a manager for one of the territories up to a VP of sales for Bruce Davis, you notice that Bruce has North and Midwest. Same application applies. He can see his territory, but it's one view of the app for everyone. And based on multi-tenant security, people have access to what they can see. Secondly, moving your spreadsheet data to a web improves accessibility. You can access it from anywhere, use any web-connected device. No need to email spreadsheets to yourself so you can access the data in another location. Finally, moving your data to a database makes your data far more useful. Once it's placed in the database, you can build anything over the top of the data, such as dashboards, reporting apps, scheduling apps, web portals, mobile apps, workflow, e-commerce, and many, many more. It opens up so many possibilities. Okay, so how can you move your spreadsheet data to a database and create web applications over the data? My section here is done. Let me turn it over to Sal Stangarone, one of the product experts here at MRC.
Thank you, Dave. Welcome, everybody. First, I'm going to show you our spreadsheet. So what I've got is a Excel spreadsheet here with some orders in it. This could be emailed to me from one of my business partners, from a customer, you name it. Maybe I want to get this information up into my database and then build a web app over it. So it's a pretty straightforward, easy process. The first thing I'm going to do is log into our Empower platform. Once I'm authenticated in there, Empower takes me to our main menu. Really, since I'm uploading data, what I'm going to do is go to our Manage Data tab, and I'm going to go to this little button that says Upload Data. I'm going to say the data source is a file. I'm going to click on that file. Empower automatically uploads it, creates a table name, which I will change, calling this new orders, and it'll create all my fields automatically for me. If I go ahead and say create, Empower gives me a warning that this table already exists because I did this earlier. I'm going to say let's drop that, let's create a brand new one, which is what I just did there. So you can see that Empower just uploaded 72 rows into this table. Now I've got my data into a database. Now the beauty of it is I can start developing any sort of web application I might be looking for. So if I want to develop a data entry application so that people can review that data and update it, I'm going to give it a description. I'll call it New Order Lookup. I'm going to pick our Display and Maintain Rows data template, and I'm going to come down here and I can see here's the data that the table that we just uploaded. I'm going to click in there. I'm going to select all my fields. I'm going to continue on. Right, and Empower will build me a nice little preview of what it's going to develop. I can go off. I can change any of that, change any of those descriptions. If I can spell and type correctly, I won't do a lot of that. I'll just do one of those in this case. Once I'm done, I can allow Empower to go off and build everything for me. So it's going to build all of the back-end web code. It's going to build my presentation layer. It will do the compiling work. deploy it to my web server, and come back and ask me what I want to do next. So if we go execute the app we just built, here's the 72 items in a lookup window. I can change my size, maybe if I want to see all of them at one time, same way I do in Excel. I can update them. I can delete. I can view records, you name it. So I can then push this beautiful web application out to any of my users by simply sending them the URL, placing it on a menu, setting up security, you name it. Hopefully that was easy enough for everybody. We will take questions at this point in time. If you can chat those in, we would appreciate it. There was one question on, is there a filtering function? That's a great question, Matt, and let's go into the app. As a matter of fact, there is, right? So you'll notice I can actually click on any column heading and resort. And if I go to selections here, I can actually filter by a bunch of different, by any field, right? Or I also have different relationships that I can filter by. So for example, if I want just men's bikes, and I believe I need to turn case sensitivity off in order to do that, which I'm going to go change right here. And I have to spell it right. And you can see that I've narrowed down my list to just men's bikes. There was another question. Where is Empower hosted? Can a company host this on their own servers? Yes. From a licensing perspective, it can be installed on-premise. It could be run in the cloud. It's really up to you and to how you'd like to use it. We support all the major databases out in the market. Another question from Tom. Your input file was XLS. Do you also support .xlsx? As a matter of fact, we do. As a matter of fact, I think that file is a .xlsx, as you can see from here. Another question, can you demonstrate how you would show sales leads by business division? Yes, absolutely. That kind of falls right back to the multi-tenant level security that Dave showed you earlier. So that rolls back to something like this, right, where based upon somebody's login, I would set up security and set up what territories or divisions they have access to in a table. And then I can securely just give them access to their leads or their information. Thank you, Thomas. Apparently there's a chat icon on the top right for any of you that are having a problem finding it. Thank you, Thomas and Matt, for that. Another good question. Can you just skip the Excel upload and take data straight from another database, i.e. DB2? Yes, as a matter of fact, you can. We've got a ETL translation feature where we can actually move data directly from any databases. Another question, can the end user add records to update the production file? Yes, as a matter of fact, they can. If I go back to that example, you'll see I've got this little plus sign here, and from here I can add any records as well, all through the same interface. Another question from Thomas, can you consolidate on various levels, salesperson, business unit, division, company? Yes, as a matter of fact, we can. Again, that's similar to this multi-tenant level security. You can see we've got this broken down by manager here, and then a level higher, which is VPs, and then a level higher, which is the president. You can actually set up those breakdowns any way you want to whatever level of detail you'd like. Great questions, gang. Another good question, is the application ACID compliant, i.e., how are conflicts managed if two people are updating the same record at the same time? That's a great question. I don't have an easy way to show that to you here, but the way it works is what will happen is the first person that updates it, it will update. The second person will get a message that says, hey, somebody else already updated this record. Please refresh your page. Another question from Michelle, can you add multiple Excel worksheets into one application? I would need to do that in multiple steps, but yes. Another question, can this be used as a web application to collect form information? Absolutely. We've got a bunch of different examples out on our Crazy Bike site, which is kind of a sample of different web forms. You can even get more sophisticated with things like here's an input form, right? And as I key a product number in here and I tab over, you'll notice that it automatically populates my description, class, and list price from my database. So you can set up applications that do things like an Ajax call to handle even more sophisticated type programs. Everything that you develop will also work both in a PC browser as well as a tablet as well as a smartphone. Another question, what types of companies are currently using Empower? It's a great question. We've actually got a wide range from your large companies like Dean Foods and Fortune 500s, Coca-Cola, to small city governments, county governments, distribution, manufacturing, you name it. Really, anybody that is running a database, anybody that has a need for either internal or external web applications, or even business-to-business applications. Another good question, do you use responsive design for tablets, smartphones, etc.? Yes, as a matter of fact, we do. We even have native functionality built in for those like finger swiping. We have one of our clients, Midland Medical, who's actually using their barcode scanner on their phone, and their clients are scanning products and entering orders directly over there through their website, all from a tablet function that they built through Empower. Another great question, can you change the look and feel and design to what extent? Yes, as a matter of fact, it's completely up to you. The look and feel, you can enter into Empower, the colors, fonts are all done through a style sheet. So you can make it look like your company or as many different companies as you'd like. Any other questions? Well, thank you. We appreciate everybody's time today. You are welcome to contact us after the fact. If you have anything, we look forward to hearing from you.